An hour later, they dropped me off at the mall. I acted like I was going in, and then they drove off. And I walked across the street to a bar, and I sat on the can there for 20 minutes, and then I forced myself to flip. When I came out, I did feel better though, a hell of a lot better. So I ordered a beer, and an old man bartender sat in front of me, and I put down a $100 bill. "Shit, son," he said. "I just opened up. I can't break it." "You can't break it? All I got are hundreds." "Well, I'll have to go into the back," he said. I sat there and nursed that beer, and then three others. The whole time this group of Mexicans were there, along with this large Viking-looking guy who had missing front teeth. I think they were roofers. Anyway, that's all I heard him talk about. Later on, as I left the bar, I guess they came up behind me in the parking lot. They said something, and I turned around, and the big toothless Viking, well, he hit me in the face. And it only took that one single punch, and I fell to the pavement. And while I was laying there, they took my wallet from me and got into their truck and left. I couldn't get up. I just laid there for a while, and the old man from the bar came out, and he saw me there. "Those son of bitches didn't pay their tab," he said. And then he looked down at me and saw my face, which I guess turns out to be pretty hard to look at. He helped me up, and I went into the bathroom there and cleaned up and came out into the main room. The old man had set a beer and a shot of whiskey and a $20 bill down. "I can't tell you how sorry I am this happened to my place," he said. "Do you think your nose is broken?" "I think it is," I said, and took a long drink. "Well, that 20 is for the beers you bought. The drinks are on the house too. But let me ask you, what in the hell were you doing with all that cash?" "I was heading to the mall to buy Christmas presents with." "Oh, there ain't much luck out there, is there?" he said and shook his head. "I guess not," I told him. "Well, I wish I could tell you who those son of a bitches were, but I ain't ever seen them before." I just nodded, and then another customer came in, and then my nose started leaking blood, so I went back to the can and tried to get it to stop. It was almost 3 o'clock when I left that place, and I was drunk and depressed as hell. So I walked down the street to the Peppermill Casino holding the last $100 close to my chest. And I spent the next 3 hours there at the blackjack table. At one point, I was even up $700. But at that time, it didn't seem to mean much. I was in the hole $1,000 from my sister, $300 from Todd, $300 from my mother. So I kept going. And for a time, it even looked like my luck would hold. Then my fat black dealer, May, well, she turned into Irma, a middle-aged Chinese woman who couldn't smile. And my luck turned. By the end, I had the cocktail waitress stopping every round, and my money just disappeared. When I finally called it, all I had was $20 and a full Heineken. I decided then I'd just hitchhike back to Phoenix. I wasn't gonna go back to the house. Not drunk, with a broken nose and presentless. Guess I'd call my mom from the road. I'd tell them all that I was sorry. Once I'd gotten out of state, once I didn't sound so drunk. I was near the end, and I knew it. I wandered around that casino for nearly an hour. When my beer was finished, I went around to the slot machines and finished any left drinks I found. There were 2 half-full Millers. And a watered-down Jack and Coke. And then near the Triple Diamond slots, I found a cold, nearly full Budweiser. So I sat down there, and I decided I'd get as drunk as I could before I had to freeze my ass out on the highway waiting for a ride. My only hope was that since it was Christmas, maybe someone would be more likely to pick up a drunk guy with a broken nose. As I sat there, darkness fell over me. And I decided, what the hell did I need an extra $20 for? If I was gonna go down, I might as well wait it out in the cold, flat broke. I took the 20 out and put it in the dollar slots. I didn't even care. I did $2 a pull. And Jesus, I was halfway through my beer and down to $8 when I hit the Triple Diamond. That's 3 diamonds across. Man, that's $4,000. The buzzer went off, and people gathered around, and I sat there, and I even started crying. And I started crying so hard that my nose started up again, and I bled on my coat.